I'm Ivan Drolik. Are you looking for a little slice of South of France in West Hollywood? Look no further. Welcome to Bagatelle Bistro. Let me go ahead and give you a little tour.
Well, I started cooking when I was young. I started cooking for my mother, friends, and family. I continued studying throughout restaurants throughout Connecticut, New York City. I went to Scottsdale Culinary Institute in Arizona, got my degree. Shortly after that, I accepted a position with Chef Thomas Keller.
Oh, wow.
At Bouchon in Las Vegas. And shortly after that, I came to Bagatelle.
And we're happy to have you here.
Yes, happy to be here.
So today, what are the dishes that you have prepared for us?
Today we actually have a new summer menu item. It is a petite heirloom tomato salad with bocconcini mozzarella, baby fennel, and pickled basil seed vinaigrette.
Now, did you just kind of take little bits of it, or is it good to break off little pieces and eat it together?
Each ingredient plays off each other. If you get a little bit of the fennel, a little bit of the tomato, and again, a little bit of the bocconcini, that really helps out. And again, the basil seed vinaigrette pulls everything together.
That's delicious. It's so refreshing, but it's not intruding of the flavors that are in the dish.
Right. One thing doesn't overpower another. Everything comes together as one, and I believe it's a light, refreshing dish for the summer months.
As it should be.
Yes.
Here in LA.
Absolutely.
And what do we have over here?
Over here, we also have a brand new menu item. Yes, this is a braised beef cheek with sauce al vera, thawed hollow peaches, pickled red onions, and a little bit of garden radish.
Your style of garnishing a dish, is that something that you picked up along the way from other chefs, or do you kind of give it your own flavor?
When you're actually like cooking or doing anything in culinary, you want it to taste great, of course, right off the bat, but you also want the eye appeal for the customers. To see it and already love it. If a dish was basically one-sided, all the same color, I feel that your imagination really doesn't, let's say, explode at the table. When you see it, if you see bright, vibrant colors, and most of all, everything plays off each other, I think your dining experience is just elevated to another level.
I have to agree. Like, the presentation is so beautiful, I can almost taste the meat, and I haven't even tried it yet.
Right.
But speaking of which, do you mind if I get a little taste?
Yes, absolutely. There you go.
Oh my God, I literally didn't have to do anything. I pressed the knife down and it was like butter, love it. And the flavors, this is amazing.
Thank you very much.
I have to say, I could never imagine eating peaches with meat.
Right.
It's outstanding because, like you said, it's a braised dish, but once you get the flavor of the peach, and the peach is nice and cold and refreshing, it completely makes me forget about the fact that I'm eating, you know, a braised piece of meat in the middle of summer.
Right, absolutely.
So that's wonderful. Bagatelle is actually opening up other locations. They have one in St. Bart's. The original one is in New York. LA just opened 2 months ago, and they are opening up in, I heard, in Las Vegas at the Tropicana.
Yes, correct.
So we expect to see more of you, and I'm definitely going to try and come back for another meal.
Absolutely, we'll be waiting.
Thank you
again.
Bagatelle is not only known for their amazing food, but their classic cocktails as well. And I've actually gotten the opportunity to step behind the bar and create one of their cocktails for you. The drink that I'm making for you today is called the Beijing Groove. The Beijing Groove was created in Barbados. The gentleman who created the drink named it the Beijing Groove because people in Barbados are Beijonians. And it was his way of paying respect to the people. So the first step in making this cocktail is you take your cucumber slices, your Thai basil, mint, and you want to go ahead and muddle this together. Muddling is key to getting all the good flavors and juices out of the cucumber and the mint and Thai basil. The flavor and the oils are all inside there. And when you hit it or muddle it, it releases the oils, and that's where you get the flavor from. So if you're ever at a bar and you see a bartender take a piece of mint and slap it, you'll know the reason. He's getting the oils to come out before he puts it in your drink. The next part in making this cocktail is you want to take a half ounce of falernum. Falernum is a bunch of different spices put into a syrup. And in my opinion, this cocktail, it's the key ingredient because it really gives it that extra flavor that it needs. So we do a half ounce of this, a half ounce of lime juice, two full ounces of coconut water, and the best part you can't forget about is the spirit, Grey Goose Le Poix. We do 1.5 ounces of Grey Goose Le Poix. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna take all these ingredients and we're gonna shake them. Give it a nice shake for a good 10, 15 seconds. It really helps combine all the juices and the flavors. Now, the garnish for the Baijiang Groove is very simple, but it really accentuates the drink and goes with it because of the fact that it has cucumber in it. Now, all you want to do is you're going to go ahead and shave a slice of cucumber. Give it a straw, and voila, we've got the Baijiang Groove. And then you go ahead and enjoy it. Because I'll tell you, this drink is amazing. It really is the ultimate summer drink. And given the fact that it has coconut water, it's like you're balancing yourself out. You got water, you got vodka. I'm a happy camper, what can I say? Right here we have Le Death in the Afternoon. It's a champagne interpretation of Hemingway's drink. It is a bit of an unconventional look because it's got squid ink in it. Now I know what you're thinking, squid ink, how do you drink something like that and not look black mouth? Folks, it's date compatible. They only use a small little dab of it. And basically it's really for the aesthetics. This cocktail consists of absinthe, pineapple juice, lemon, vanilla sugar, and it's topped off with champagne. You can go ahead and take these recipes home and make them at home. It's kind of a cool thing if you're having a cocktail party at your own house and you know, you bust out some bar tools and make your guests some fancy cocktails. It's more about what goes into the drink. The time, the love, the preparation, and enjoying the drink for what it is, more so than drinking a bunch of shots and getting drunk. I want to thank Bagatelle Bistro for giving a little slice of South of France and West Hollywood. And I especially want to thank you guys for watching. My name is Ivan Jirovic. Bon appetit. That's amazing. That really is good.